The International Court of Justice has ordered Israel to take all reasonable measures to prevent genocidal acts in Gaza. In their interim finding, the judges did not order an immediate ceasefire and called for Palestinian armed groups to release the remaining hostages captured on October the 7th. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu said his country abides by international law and will continue the war against Hamas, not the Palestinian civilians. South Africa, which initiated the case on behalf of the Palestinian people, said the result was a decisive victory.
At the UN's highest court, judges demanded the protection of civilians, but stopped short of ordering what those struggling to survive in Gaza really want: an end to the conflict.
The court is acutely aware of the extent of the human tragedy that is unfolding in the region and is deeply concerned about the continuing loss of life and human suffering.
Israel must ensure its troops do not commit genocidal acts against Palestinians.
In particular, A, killing members of the group, B, causing serious bodily or mental harm to members of the group, C, deliberately inflicting on the group conditions of life calculated to bring about its physical destruction in whole or in part, and D, imposing measures intended to prevent births within the group.
Israel has also been instructed to prevent and punish incitement of genocide by government officials, allow humanitarian assistance into Gaza, and submit a report to the court within 1 month detailing how it has complied with the measures imposed. Judges also called for the immediate release of hostages being held by Hamas.
All parties to the conflict in the Gaza Strip are bound by international humanitarian law.
The ruling is legally binding and cannot be appealed, but there's no enforcement mechanism. South Africa, which brought the case to the ICJ, had asked the court to order an immediate ceasefire. That was dismissed.
No way that I'm going to say I'm disappointed. I hoped for it, but the fact of delivering humanitarian aid, the fact of taking measures that reduce the levels of harm against persons who have no role in what Israel is combating, for me, requires a ceasefire.
After more than half a century of occupation, dispossession, oppression, and apartheid, the Palestinian people's cries for justice have been heeded by an eminent organ of the United Nations.
With talks about a potential 2-month ceasefire ongoing and some aid, although not enough, being let into Gaza, Israel argues it is already complying with international law and its operation will continue.
Our war is against Hamas terrorists, not against Palestinian civilians. We will continue to facilitate humanitarian assistance and to do our utmost to keep civilians out of harm's way, even as Hamas uses civilians as human shields. We will continue to do what is necessary to defend our country and defend our people. The charge of genocide leveled against Israel is not only false, it's outrageous, and decent people everywhere should reject it.
Israel's security minister, with a blunt response to the ruling, Haig Schmeig, he wrote on social media. The court has not ruled Israel has committed genocide. A decision on that charge could still be years away.
Just being here, just the fact that the state of Israel is being put on trial for genocide, something that we are survivors of, something that we experienced, is absolutely absurd.
For pro-Palestinian protesters outside the court, disappointment a ceasefire was not ordered, but hope global pressure on Israel will now increase.
I am very happy about what I heard. I think it's a step forward for a ceasefire that we're all demanding right now.
Israel's biggest supporter says the ruling is consistent with the US position.
Israel has the right to take action against the terrorists of that on the October 7th attack, that they have an obligation to be mindful of minimizing civilian casualties, that they have an obligation to assist the international community to get humanitarian assistance. And all these are things that we have been pushing and urging for as well.
Israel has been ordered to change the way it's conducting its war, not to stop it. Ben Lewis, SBS World News.
Let's go into the implications of this ruling now with the reporter Alex Cadier. He joins us from The Hague in the Netherlands. Alex, good evening to you. What do you understand by the court saying that there is, quote, plausibility to South Africa's claims that Palestinian people need protection against genocide?
Well, Anthony, it would imply that the court felt there was some evidence that could represent breaches of the Genocide Convention. And that's why some of these provisional orders, as you heard in Ben Lewis's report, were granted as requested by South Africa. I'll bring you through a couple of the other ones that were particularly interesting. One of them was that Israel shall take measures, all measures in its power, to prevent the direct incitement of genocide and has to report back in a month on how it is doing that. And that has been interpreted as a warning to some Israeli officials who have made some rather controversial comments directed at the people of Gaza. And that may mean that Israeli officials in the coming weeks mind their words a little bit more in the way that they talk about this conflict, to prevent the court interpreting some of these statements as incitement to genocide. So it's certainly a ramping up of accountability, a ramping up of the scrutiny of Israel's military operations in Gaza, also saying that Israel needs to make sure its armed forces do not breach the Genocide Convention in any way, and allows open humanitarian access to Gaza. And that is what they will be looking at in a month's time here at the court when Israel presents its report on how it's done on these provisional measures. Of course, the big one, a full ceasefire by Israeli forces in Gaza, was not ordered by the court, and that would have been seen as a win for the Israeli government. The next steps will be that report by the Israeli government coming here to show what they have done to abide by this court's order. But they also have the option of broadly ignoring the court's order, because the enforcement of these orders is down to the UN Security Council. And if the United States feels the ICJ ruling has been unfair or has not fairly represented the Israeli position, they could veto any enforcement action. These are on the preliminary measures. The court will then work on the final verdict as to whether or not Israel has committed genocidal acts. And that may take years, Anton.
So a long way to go yet. That's reporter Alex Cadier updating us live from The Hague. Israel's Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu says the ICJ's interim decision not to order a ceasefire means the court supports Israel's right to defend itself against the October 7th attacks. Palestinians have met the court's finding with mixed emotions.
Under clouds of smoke from relentless bombardment of the Strip, the hopes of those displaced pegged on a court half a world away. The decision was met with disappointment by many on the streets of Gaza.
We were waiting for the International Court of Justice to issue stricter decisions than that, such as a ceasefire, our return to our homes in the north, and stopping the bloodshed in the Gaza Strip.
The International Court was supposed to at least demand an immediate ceasefire, but unfortunately, this did not happen.
Some were relieved to hear recognition of their suffering.
It is a precedent for the first time that judges from different nationalities unanimously agreed that we are suffering, that we have problems.
In the West Bank, Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas and members of his cabinet watched the ICJ session from his office in Ramallah. Gatherings were held like this one at a cinema to watch the court hand down its findings. A tempered response from Ramallah's mayor. It's a good first step, he said, but a long journey ahead.
If at least we can take humanitarian support for our people in Gaza, and to make sure that less killing takes place every day, and that the war is on its way to stop.
The Palestinian Authority foreign minister with this response.
States now have clear legal obligations to stop Israel's genocidal war on the Palestinian people in Gaza and to make sure that they are not complicit. The ICJ order is an important reminder that no state is above the law.
At the United Nations headquarters in New York, the decision hailed as historic.
If one to look at the provisional measures separately and collectively, it gives the clear message that in order to do all the things that they're asking for, you need a ceasefire for it to happen.
But while the next steps are considered, no change yet evident on the front lines. As rocket fire from Gaza into southern Israel continues, so does intense Israeli bombing in Khan Yunis. Here at the Nusayrat refugee camp, 15 people were killed in an airstrike, including a baby. Food shortages increasingly critical, some resorting to eating animal feed, as the UN says aid trucks continue to be held up trying to cross the border. The death toll this week climbing above 26,000, with over 64,000 injured, 1.7 million displaced. Alexandra Jones, SBS World News.